Welcome back. We are so excited to have our entertainment correspondent, Francine Brokaw, here, and she's going to tell us what is exciting about 2022 in TVs and movies. Francine, thanks so much for coming and joining us. I know you have your own show, and it's really great that you will come and join ours as well. And thank you so much.
My pleasure. You know, with COVID, a lot of things have been put on hold, but 2022 is going to be jam-packed full of TV and movie, TV and theater shows. So let's get right to it because I have a lot of things.
All right. Okay, good. Because I need some new stuff to watch for TV.
Me too. Okay.
Yeah. What's coming down the pipeline that's going to be interesting?
Well, you know, we all loved Hallmark Channel. They've got a new a trilogy of movies. It's called The Wedding Veil. And it starts January 8th. I don't have the exact dates of the other ones, but the first one will be January 8th. Mm-hmm. And then they're bringing back the Aurora Tea Garden. Mm-hmm. So that's a very popular show with them. Okay, so then we also have a very interesting in April. I'm looking forward to PBS because they have Ken Burns, who does fabulous documentaries.
I love Ken Burns.
Got one on Benjamin Franklin.
Ooh!
And I think
Benjamin Franklin is, we need a Hamilton. We need a musical about Benjamin Franklin, don't you? Maybe one about him flying his kite.
Yeah.
Let's go fly a kite, you know, use that one.
Would be cool. That's a good idea. You should pitch that.
I think,
Lin-Manuel, are you listening?
Yeah, I think that he's really a fascinating historical figure. If I could meet anyone in the past, first I would meet Jesus because he's so interesting to me, obviously. And then second, I would meet Benjamin Franklin. He'd be my number two.
That's interesting.
I just think that he is so amazing. Just did so much for our country. So anyway.
I like Thomas Jefferson, but yeah, let's go with Benjamin Franklin this year. Okay, Acorn TV, which is a streaming service that I think a lot of people have been clued into these days. They've got a new series called Under the Vines. They started, but it's going to be returning in 2022 for a second season. And they even they got the second season renewal before they even started the
Oh wow!
Because it's really a fun show.
What's
it's
it
really
about?
A fun show. Okay. These two people inherit this winery, uh-huh. and they don't know each other. They're from England and one's from New Zealand or Australia. I don't. Anyway, it takes place down in the South Pacific, and they inherit this winery. They don't know what to do, but they're going to make a go of it. In the meantime, the neighboring winery wants to buy them out because they know that they've got some good grapes there, and we'll see what happens.
Interesting.
It's interesting.
I've been seeing a lot of TV shows pop up where it's more rustic and remote. Think about Yellowstone, mm-hmm. Virgin River. It sounds like this might be kind of similar, but I love that. I love how it's not just about the big city anymore. It's about these little areas and pockets of.
And speaking of rustic and remote, my husband is just totally obsessed with Heartland.
Yeah. That is my number one. Love Heartland.
And I think
that one.
You have to get up Faith and Family. That's a fabulous. They have so many Christmas movies this year, but they have some really, really good stuff. I just got them and it's my new obsession right now.
Well, I have a channel called Friendly TV. It's FRNDLY TV. Mm-hmm. And they have all the Hallmark channels. They have GAC, the Great American Channel, which is the mm-hmm. split off from Hallmark. They have Up Faith and Family, Lifetime. So literally it's Christmas with a click of a button, number one, but Heartland, which has been hard for me to find anywhere because the Canadian broadcasting doesn't really link with us here in the US, except we're on a multi-year delay. But in that particular format, you can see from season one, they're going to be releasing season 15 this year. And so just think about it, 15 seasons of any show. It's crazy, right?
Yeah. Speaking this of 15 is seasons.
So cool. I'm looking on it right now, guys. I couldn't even wait.
On February 26th, the 15th season of Murdoch Mysteries.
Dude, on Francine, Ovation. I saw your interview with the cast on Murdoch Mysteries of your show.
I'm going to try and do that again.
I'm so obsessed with the lead on Murdoch Mysteries. Like, I love that. I love Julia and Murdoch. They have such a, you know, they're a really interesting couple.
They're really good people too. I mean, and the show is so, I mean, 15 seasons, you got to be popular to have that.
You know? Yeah, right.
We went through all of them in about a month, Jeff and I did.
Have you, is anybody obsessed, were you obsessed with Sex and the City at all?
I never got into that. No.
Well, the new spinoff, And Just Like That, has just started on HBO Max. It's,
what do you think?
Very woke. It's, my husband walked through while I was watching, while I was preparing, and he said, you know, sometimes you don't want to see your old character, when they were young and peppy, as seniors. It just kind of takes away. So I don't know. A lot of people are liking it. I'm hearing from both sides that it's good and bad.
Good and bad. I'm actually surprised. Like you said, Lauren, shockingly, you never got into it. I would have totally expected it because New York fashion.
Yeah, I know, right? And I just couldn't. I never got into the series. Part of it was that it was at the time you didn't have so much recording going on and series and you were committed to watch it when you could watch it. Watch the two movies for just that reason, though, the fashion and the locales. I thought the movies were campy and super fun.
I wish they had done this as a movie instead of a series.
Originally, I thought it was supposed to be a movie. So when I heard it was I was surprised.
Yes, but it doesn't have the fashion and the jewelry. I love the jewelry in the original series. So it doesn't really have a lot of that. It doesn't focus that much on that. It's more on the characters, I think. And it's a little bit deeper, darker. Mm-hmm. But let's see. Let's look at, another thing on Acorn that I absolutely love is the Madame Blanc Mysteries. And it's so cute. It's this woman, Mrs. White, and in French, it's Blanc. But Mrs. White is in London and she's an antique dealer. She knows everything about antiques and gosh, everything. She's just an encyclopedia. Anyway, her husband gets killed in France. So she goes down there to find out what happened. And in the meantime, she's in this little town and all these little mysteries and murders and everything starts popping up and she helps the police. She's hired by the police to help because she knows everything. And it's a cute show. I like it. I really
That's
do.
Super interesting.
Yeah. Look it up.
His mysterious death.
Yes.
Amy does. And Amy puts this stuff up in real time while we're talking about it.
I can't wait because I've been waiting for a new TV series. This is like fascinating to me. All right.
But I love that show. Though. And, you know, For All Mankind, it's the space movie where the Americans and the Russians have this race to the moon to set up their scientific and communities on the moon. That's going to return for season two. I've been anxiously waiting for
that one. What's that one called?
For All Mankind. It's on Apple TV Plus. Yeah. I just got the newsletter from Shirley MacLaine, and she is right now currently in New York filming the second season of Only Murders in the Building. And have you seen that? The first season.
I love that show. It is.
She'll be
so
on the second.
Good. It's interesting. That one's with it's Steve Martin.
And adding Shirley MacLaine this time around would be kind of interesting. Mm-hmm. Very interesting. Okay, let's see. Outlander, March 6th, season 6 on Stars. Now, a lot of people have been writing to me asking, when is Outlander coming? They've been anxious for this. So here it is, season 6, March 6th on Stars. That's when it's going to start.
Jamie's a hottie. That's all I'm going to say.
Dirty Jobs, Mike Rowe. They're bringing Dirty Jobs back. And he's had several series since Dirty Jobs, but it was so popular. Discovery is bringing him back for that. And he's really a nice guy. I mean, he's so sweet. I love talking with him. Mm-hmm. He's adorable. Okay, let's go into movies, theaters. Now, Turning Red, March 11th from Pixar, Disney Pixar. And I don't know if your cousin Hiram is involved in that or not, but
super fast plug? Okay, so Hiram, my cousin on Disney Plus, has done all of the Olaf shorts, where Olaf acts out all the other Disney movies. That's like, he totally did that whole thing by himself, and he's responsible for the character of Olaf. Which we're I'm very proud. So
he's genius. He's an animation genius. I've met him once, and I would love to get him on my show. So if you can talk to him, please tell him to contact me. Get him on and we can talk about that.
On it.
Okay, so that's Turning Red from Disney Pixar. Sonic the Hedgehog 2, which a lot of people grew up with the Sonic the Hedgehog. It's coming out April 8th. Mm-hmm. So the first movie, was pretty cute, you know, as an adult watching it. I was never involved with Sonic the Hedgehog, but a lot of people are. Downton Abbey, second movie, March 18th.
Interesting. Do you like Mary or do you not like Mary?
Oh, you have to like Lady Mary because she's got her part in the family. Everybody's got a different part in the family.
True.
You come from a family where people play their roles. Come on.
That's a really good point. I agree.
And speaking of sequels, we've got Legally Blonde 3, May 20th.
Oh, I don't know.
I kind of iffy on that. We'll see. I did not care that much for the second one.
Second one was not good. The first one was literally my favorite show. When I got divorced, I watched it, no joke, every single day for 3 months, cried every time, said, if she can do it, so can I. That I literally did. Like, that saved me through my divorce.
She's fun actually to talk with too. I like her. Like you said, the second movie didn't live up to it. Let's see what the third one does.
All right.
Okay, another sequel, Top Gun Maverick. Now I looked forward to this a year ago or a year and a half ago when COVID hit, they canceled movies. Top Gun Maverick comes out in theaters. They finally got a date, May 27th. And I'm looking forward to that one. He's an instructor. And it's going to be interesting to see how that evolves.
Yeah.
Jurassic World Domination, June 10th.
We've got a lot of sequels going on here. A lot of Jurassic Worlds. I just don't even know how the planet is still alive because so many dinosaurs have come back. It's amazing.
Mission Impossible 7, believe it or not, September 30th. Now, all these dates are set, but they can be moved. So they're not set in stone, so they can move. But right now, Mission Impossible 7 is set for September 30th, and the Avatar 2 movie is December 16th. So that should be a Christmas time release.
Sounds like they're making a big push to get us back into the theaters, which will happen. But
yeah. You know, you got to hand it to Tom Cruise, man. Like, of all those movies, he's starring in two of them. It's amazing.
He's got so much going on. Let's see. Going back to Pixar, they have Pixar's Lightyear, June 17th. And again, I don't know if Hiram is involved in that because they're Pixar. And you know what? Next year, 2022, or this year, when it's there.
Lightyear is about Buzz Lightyear. I see. And then Turning Red looks really fun. It's about this.
That was the one I'm looking forward to.
About this girl that turns into a giant panda when she gets excited.
The Queen's Platinum Jubilee year. Can you imagine living without Queen Elizabeth II? Oh my gosh. I don't have any specifics. I'm trying to get them as we speak. But I'm sure a lot of the streaming services and on YouTube, you'll be able to see some of the festivities live or recorded and then represented to us over here across the pond. And I'm looking forward to that because I want to see how the family gets together and how the country supports her, especially after this tumultuous year that she's been through. Mm-hmm. I really feel sorry for her.
Her health. I really do. I think she's an amazing woman.
Yeah, she really is amazing. She's weathered so much. Experienced so much.
And this last year has been I know she said the other year when all the divorces happened were her annus horribilis, but I think this last year has been even worse, especially with the death of Prince Philip. But 2022 Platinum Jubilee should be up and festive, and we'll see what happens, see what they do. And when I get more information,
a viewing show together, if there's a way for us to all stream at the same time and watch together.
Let's do a viewing party. That would be so much fun. I love that idea.
And I'm trying to get some more information about lockdown, what exactly they're going to be scheduling. A lot of things are, you know, with this, with COVID and everything, things are liquid. They don't know exactly, but they do have one specific date set for the big bank holiday, 4 days. So they're going to really be pulling out the stops for her.
That's wonderful.
Francine, thank you so much. I'm so excited. Now we have something to look forward to. And I know Amy's going to start watching this weekend. So put her report back and then I can tune in too.
Definitely. Thank you so much, Francine. You've saved my weekends now.
My pleasure, y'all. Enjoy your viewing.
Thank you. And we'll be back.